In this video, I'd like to review multiplying binomials with you. A binomial is simply a polynomial that has two pieces or two terms. So for example, x plus 4 times x minus 2. So what we would like to do is we'd like to multiply these together. How do we know we're multiplying them? Because when we look in between these parentheses, we don't see any symbol. We don't see a plus sign, so we're not adding. We don't see a minus sign, so we're not subtracting. When they're right next to each other, that means we're multiplying. Now, essentially, when you multiply two binomials together, you need to distribute twice. Often what I find is students who are taught this in high school have been taught an acronym or an abbreviation called FOIL. And so I'm going to do it that way with you because that might be familiar. FOIL stands for first, outside, inside, and last. Let me write it over here where more of you can maybe see it. So FOIL, so first, outside, inside, and last. And it's simply a way to remind you that you really have to distribute twice. And if you go through letter by letter, then you won't forget any part of the distributing you need. So for example, I want to do one that's a little harder with you, one where we might have a number here in front of the x, just to make sure that that won't hang you up in any way. So what if we had something like 2x minus 3 times 3x plus 2? Again, if you want to remember the acronym FOIL or the abbreviation FOIL, we're going to go for the first. 2 times 3 is 6xx, in other words, 6x squared. The outside ones, 2x and 2, that's going to be a positive 4x. The inside ones, a negative 3 and a 3, that's negative 9 and an x. And finally, the last ones, so negative 3 times 2 is negative 6. And then notice that, again, these two here, we can combine together. So we're going to have 6x squared, 4x minus 9x is negative 5x. And here we have a negative 6. So our answer would be 6x squared minus 5x minus 6. So we did an easy one. We did one that's a little harder. I want to remind you that there's no shortcuts on these. Sometimes when you're given a multiplication of binomial problem that's not written out, people are tempted to take a shortcut that will always give you the wrong answer. What if we had x plus 3 squared? People often make the mistake of thinking that you can just square x and square 3 and you get x squared plus 9. That shortcut doesn't work. No shortcuts. So if you should see a problem like this, make sure to write it out. This means write this out twice. X plus 3, x plus 3. And then once that's done, you're going to again use your first, outside, inside, last. So the first ones, x times x is x squared. The outside ones, x times 3 is 3x. The inside ones, 3 times x is 3x. And then the last ones, 3 times 3 is 9. And what we should do is combine the similar terms in here. So a final answer would be x squared plus 6x plus 9. So hopefully you can see that if you were to accidentally take the tempting but wrong shortcut of just squaring x and squaring 3, you would be missing this middle term here. So when you see one like this, I really recommend just write it out and then apply FOIL like you always would. All right, so let's try some. We'll try an easy one that's a little harder, and then one where I will tempt you to try a shortcut, but you'll remember just to write it out and work it out. So see if you can do these. There's an easy one. Let's do one that's a little harder. And then let's try this one. right, so I hope you pressed pause and tried them. Let's go ahead and work them out. So on this one, we'll multiply the first ones together. X times x is x squared. We'll multiply the outside ones together, and that'll give us a negative 4x. We'll multiply the inside ones together. That'll give us a negative 6x. And finally, we'll multiply these last ones together. Now don't forget, it's a negative term times a negative term, so that's going to give us a positive 24. And in the end, check for similar terms, usually right here in the middle. We have x squared minus 10x plus 24. And so that's your answer for the first one. Let's do the second one the same way. We'll multiply the first ones together. So we have 3 times 4, 12. And then xx, in other words, x squared. We'll multiply the outside ones together. 3 times negative 5 is negative 15. So we have negative 15x. We'll multiply the inside ones together. 1 times 4 is 4. So we have 4x. And finally, we'll multiply the last ones together. 1 times negative 5 is negative 5. Again, we have similar terms right here in the middle. Our final answer is going to be 12x squared minus 11x minus 5. And finally, let's take a look at this last one here. It was x plus 6 to the second power. And so remember, it'll be tempting just to square each of these, but that'll be wrong every time. If we were to take a moment to write it out, x plus 6 times x plus 6, and we were to start with x times x, that'll be x squared. The outside ones here will give us a 6x. The inside ones here will give us another 6x. And 6 times 6 is going to be 36. Combining the similar terms in the middle, the final answer would be x squared plus 12x plus 36. And that's a quick recap of multiplying binomials.